Hello everyone, and welcome back to the channel for some more Star Wars Battlefront 2 news. And today, oh my god, we have some amazing news from the lead hero designer for Battlefront 2, who confirmed today a ton of hero buffs that will be coming with the next update later this month. And when I say a ton, I don't mean one or two, I mean a ton. We are getting a pretty substantial change to several heroes, so let's not waste any time and just get right into it. And I'm gonna take these one by one, starting out with the ones that I am most personally excited about. First up, and this is by far the best change on this list, and probably the biggest change overall, Boba Fett is getting a ton of love with the next patch, as he will be getting a health buff, the ability to dodge in midair and also recover from being knocked out of the air, and a dot reticle on his EE3 blaster. When it comes to the health buff, all I have to say is about time. I definitely agree that Boba should have lower health than some other heroes, just due to his ability to fly, but the fact that he can be killed in 3 swings to the back by most lightsaber heroes is just ridiculous. Just an extra 50 to 100 HP will make a huge difference for his survivability, and overall I'm just really glad to see this change. When it comes to them implementing a system where he can not only dodge, but also recover from being knocked out of the sky, this is just really, really interesting. Personally, I've always thought they should just change what can actually knock Boba out of the sky, as currently even a blurg with explosive shot can take him down completely, and I do enjoy trolling Boba players, but I definitely don't like it when it happens to me. I think things like Chewie's bowcaster and Han's detonite should absolutely take him down, but I shouldn't be able to hit Boba with one shot from a pistol and send him crashing to the ground, because he is a hero, he's not just your regular scrub player. But if they are indeed adding mid-air dodges and a recovery system, this should make getting knocked out of the sky less of a big deal, because you can fix that before you smash into the ground and get wrecked. I really hope that his recovery system ignores certain knockdowns, as it will make chasing him down in Heroes vs. Villains really annoying if you can't even guarantee a pull down with something like Anakin's pull, but I guess we'll have to wait and see. For the dot reticle for Boba's EE3, I'm not sure exactly how this will be implemented, but I hope this means they also tighten up the spread a lot. I don't think this means we're getting an ADS for Boba, I think they're just taking away the huge clunky reticle he currently has and adding a precision dot, but that means they also need to tighten up the spread of his blaster, or the regular dot is just not going to change anything. Either way, amazing changes for Boba. While he's not bad in his current state, he is definitely outclassed by a lot of the other villains, and I'm glad they're finally showing him some long overdue love, as he has been in a weird place for a very, very long time. Next up, for those of you who are fans of Vader like myself, he is getting a pretty massive buff with the next patch, and seeing as Vader is already a top 3 villain, I can only imagine what this is going to do to Vader overall. Hopefully it doesn't make him too powerful. Vader will be having his stamina regen delay reduced, his lightsaber damage increased, and also will be receiving damage reduction during his force choke. For the stamina and force choke changes, I am totally on board. His stamina was his biggest weakness for me, as compared to pretty much any other hero, he just takes way too long to get it back, and after they made attacks impossible went out of stamina, and also took away Focused Rage's unlimited stamina and changed it to just a reduction, Vader took a huge hit. Vader's biggest drawback is supposed to be his slow movement alone, so I'm glad they're making steps to fix his stamina issue. His force choke damage reduction I'm also okay with. Once they introduced huge damage reduction for other similar abilities, I think it's only fair that Vader gets it as well. The only change I am concerned about is his lightsaber damage. I never really had a problem with it, to be honest. I wouldn't mind if they upped his focused rage damage to 150 from 140, just so he can one-shot troopers with that ability active, but anything more than that, and Vader is just going to outclass like everyone, and we definitely don't want another Anakin situation on our hands. Overall, I love two of these three changes, and when it comes to the third, we don't know exactly what is changing, so I'll just hold off until we get the details before making a final judgment call on that one. Moving on, and this is a change that will apparently have an effect on all blaster heroes, as they are getting an across-the-board buff to their health regeneration. Again, this is something that should have been changed a long time ago. Only 150 health regen for heroes is just not enough, and really is not even playing ground when you consider some heroes can have 400 plus with star cards. I think just upping it to 200 will make a huge difference for heroes like Chewbacca, who is also getting a straight-up health buff, which should help a lot, and others like Lando and, of course, Boba, who will see the benefits of this on top of all the other buffs. Leia is really the only one that's in a good place regen-wise, and of course Boss, who can just regen everything, but after DICE nerfed the heck out of all the stuns and added so many really strong lightsaber heroes, the blaster heroes have just kind of taken a backseat for the most part, as most are just not as good as they used to be, with the exception of like Han and Boss, who are, as always, still beastly. Hopefully this is a step in the right direction just to set things right. I think for someone like Chewbacca, a health buff isn't going to be quite enough to fix him for Galactic Assault, as he was just designed with a kit that's built for one mode and not the other, but at the very least this will make him significantly more viable, although he is coming from a pretty low point in non-hero modes to begin with. The two heroes we received for The Last Jedi season, Finn and Captain Phasma, are also finally getting a way overdue buff, as both will be getting their blaster damage increased. In the case of Captain Phasma, all I have to say is about time. In Heroes vs. Villains, she is good if you're willing to play just by camping by your droid, but in Galactic Assault, she is the most situational hero ever. And while she does have a few phases where she can really shine, overall, due to her blaster's pathetically low damage, it is just so easy to take out a Phasma in a 1v1 as even a trooper, as you can just get so many shots off on her before her blaster will even begin to kill you. When you compare Phasma's blaster to Iden's TL-50, Bosk's Relby, or Han's DL-44, it's almost a joke how low the stats are on that gun. Not to mention how insane the spread is at any sort of distance when you first start firing. This damage buff should really help her out in particular. For Finn, I mean, it just sounds like they're undoing what they initially did to him way back in like December. When Finn first released, he was a beast, his gun was absolutely great, his Deadeye was strong, and overall Finn was just a really fun hero. But then they decided to nerf not only his Deadeye damage, but also his regular blaster damage, which nobody was asking for, making his regular blaster very, very weak for a hero blaster, and that's just how he's remained since. I'm not sure if he's also getting a buff to his Deadeye blaster damage or just for his non-Deadeye blaster, but either way this should help quite a lot. I think all DICE needs to do after this is just remove the ridiculous movement penalty Finn gets with Big Deal and allow him to move freely, and then he'll be in a way better place than he is currently, because in HVV, he's one of the weakest picks just due to that huge, huge movement penalty. It gets him killed so quickly. After this, we have a bunch of single buffs for a variety of different heroes. Grievous will be getting a damage buff to Unrelenting Advance, and also a fix for that ability, which there's no specifics, but I can only imagine means it will be more reliable as a block. This is great. Unrelenting Advance is probably the ability I trust the least in the game. Shots just go right through it all the time, and overall, I only use it as an absolute last resort if I have no stamina left to block. The damage buff will be nice too, but I think no matter what, this ability is just going to be somewhat situational just due to its overall impracticality. Luke will be getting a damage buff to his regular lightsaber attacks. I do think this is also a good change, as while Luke is already one of my favorite heroes from a fun perspective, with the addition of Anakin and also Rey just having been a beast from the onset, and Yoda getting so much love lately, Luke's regular attacks have always felt a little bit light in comparison, and I'm glad they're upping his damage a bit. When you combine that with his already incredibly fast stamina regen, this should help put Luke in an even better place than he already was. Obi-Wan is also getting a buff to his mind trick to make it last longer. Again, I totally approve of this change. I think a slight buff to the length is a good idea, as currently it's just a tad too short, and DICE has just done a great job lately of making Obi-Wan a competitive hero. When he first released, he was extremely weak for Heroes vs. Villains, but he's continually become better and better, and this should move the needle even further. Finally, Yoda is getting a speed buff. I assume this just means his movement speed will be faster, which is fine, I guess. It's not really something I ever thought was a problem, but I hope this means he's getting a speed buff to his attack speed, as his saber swings are very slow, and with how easy it is to roll out of lightsaber attacks, that can get really, really annoying pretty quickly. One additional thing, the hero designer did respond to a fan over on Twitter, asking if DICE could possibly make Maul's saber throw hitbox larger, or just have him throw his saber sideways like Vader, to which Guillaume jokingly responded saying he hopes the devs hear him, and seeing as he is a dev and the hero designer, hopefully that means it's a change we can expect in the next update or maybe a little bit later. Well guys, that will do it for today's video. This really does restore my faith in the hero team over at DICE. The last patch was filled with decisions Well guys, that is going to do it for today's video, and overall, this really restores my faith in the hero team over at DICE. The last patch was filled with decisions that made it seem like they hadn't even played their own game, but this at the very least shows they listened to the feedback and are responding accordingly. If you enjoyed today's video, please be sure to drop a like, and if you are new around here, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, if you aren't already, make sure you are following me over on Instagram. I just received my silver play button for hitting 100,000 followers on this channel, and I posted a picture over there. So I also often do Q&As and giveaways and stuff almost always on Instagram, so just make sure you're following me over there so you don't miss anything. Anyways guys, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.